Baby, shame on me, you want to make with the 1+1 or 2. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Pretty little black skin girl. Caribbean beauty. Caribbean cutie.
So, Gwan people, welcome back to my channel. I'm your girl Kaise A. So, if you are new, welcome. Big up yourself. Respect. Make sure say you subscribe down below. Hit that subscribe button down below. Alright, you're messing up. Yeah. So, alright, guys, in today's video, I will be doing this distress butterfly faux locks type thing. I posted it on my story the other day. I showed you all and everybody loved it. So this is what I did. I videoed it and I'm showing you all. This is what I did to achieve that look. All right. So the first step is you want to ensure your hair is clean, right? Wash your hair, get it clean. And I'm doing single individual locks. So what I did is I part my hair into small boxes, small cubes, and I'm braiding it all the way down, or I braided it halfway and I twist the rest of it down to the end. You can do that, or you can just braid it all the way down, but I would not recommend you to twist it because the twist is a little bit too loose and you don't want, whenever you put that crochet here in, it actually just pull up the next day. Like, you don't need that. So I would recommend that you start by plaiting or braiding your hair, but just don't start it by twisting it. I wouldn't recommend that. All right, so you just want to do that to your entire hair. And also I use shine and jam because I wanted that sleek, neat finish. But you don't necessarily have to use shine and jam. You can go ahead and use other braiding gel or jam. There are a lot of them out there. Just find one, use. Just ensure that the ones that you're using doesn't have the white residue in it. All right. So the hair I will be using is from Amazon, of course. I just went on there and find some passion twist hair. It is in 22 inch. I will leave a link to it down below, and I'm using the color number 4, I believe, right? It's kind of like brown. So I'm taking 2 strands of hair from a pack and I unravel those from the end going all the way up, and those 2 pieces I am passing them through my hair using a crochet needle. And now I am going to go ahead to just fix the hair in place how I want it. I'm going to be using, as you can see, one side is shorter than the other, right? And the shorter side, I am holding that in my hand while using the longer side to wrap around my hair to create that locks, right? And guys, you want to ensure that you make around 4 wraps to the roots, just to ensure that it is secure, it is sturdy, it will not move, you know. And then you do some light wraps. You don't have to do it very tight. It all depends on the type of look that you're going for. If you want it to be a lot distress or a lot butterfly, to achieve the butterfly look, right? As you can see, I am wrapping the hair over my finger, right, over my nails, and that will kind of like push out some of the hair so that it doesn't look all that neat. It gives it that distressed look, right? So as you wrap, you just want to pass the hair over your finger, that will just kind of give it that effect. So that's how it is. When you see all of those videos on Instagram and all over the place, they look good, right? And you wonder like, how the hell they get that? That is what they do. They use their thumb or any one of their fingers, you know, and just pass the ear over it, and that create that distressed butterfly type thing. Another thing too, if you're not comfortable with, you know, using your thumb to create that distressed look, you can also, as long as you secure the hair to the root, you can also just lightly wrap it around to create that bohemian distressed type thing. I mean, it might not look as distressed or as butterfly. I'm still using that word, as butterfly, or as this one is, but it will still give you a look, right? It might not be like this, but it will be somewhat similar. It will give you a nice bohemian distress type thing, but it's not gonna look butterfly-y as this one. I'm so crazy, but guys, I know you all know what I mean, all right? So yeah, so as you can see, when I got to the end of where I wanted my desired length, I just bend the hair and kept on wrapping everything all the way up. I wrap and wrap until I had nothing left. Everything was all wrapped into each other, and yeah, I just roll it in my palm and that seals itself. So again, I am going to be showing you guys in this clip the very same thing, how I got it done. And like I said before, I used two pieces of the hair. I unraveled them and I passed that through the I passed it through my hair using a crochet needle, sorry. And as you see, I secured it into the roots of my hair by wrapping it around a few times, four or more, to about an inch, right? And after which I'm gonna start creating that butterfly effect, right? And some of them I wrap them pretty much tight because I just wanted a different look, and this was my first time attempting this, so I was just, you know, going, just doing all sorts of things. So some might be a little bit tighter than some, but after a few days, like, everything just gets swell and it just looks so good. I'm telling you all, it looked so damn good. Another thing too, guys, if you are wrapping the hair down and the hair that you're using is finished, you can just grab another piece of hair and just start wrapping it in. You don't have to crochet it back. You don't have to crochet it into your hair again and start wrapping it down. You can just pick up where the hair stop and just start wrapping from there. Eventually everything is going to lock in, right? And when you get to the end of the hair, I'm going to show you another way in which you can do it, right? So as you can see, I wrap the longer piece until I had nothing more to wrap, and for the remaining of this hair, right, I am splitting it into two, and then I'm gonna wrap each side up until it's finished. And that is another way that you can use to secure the hair, right? Instead of just when you get to the end or to the desired length, you just fold everything up and wrapping it upwards. You can do it like this and you will achieve the same results. So after I finish wrapping, I just take the hair into my palm and do a little roll, and this will help to secure it even more, right? And you don't need no wax, you don't need no candles, you don't need no glue, nothing like that. It will seal itself, right? Look at that. Isn't that looking so scrumptious, so delicious? Mwah, right? Come on, I know it does. So I will be repeating this step again, so guys, just go ahead and watch and see what I'm doing. One thing though, I'm not going to sit here and tell you all that this hairstyle was completed within 5 hours. Anybody telling you that? A lie. This took a while to do, because to sit down and to wrap those passion twists here around your hair, it is not easy. Your hands do get tired. So it did take me a couple of hours. I probably would say 8-9 hours to complete it or more. So what I would tell you guys to do is to maybe start the process, to do it in a 2-day period. Plait, start by braiding your hair one day and then take on the wrapping process the following day. So yeah, and you will complete it. Right, so now I've finished. I'm just gonna go ahead and add a few jewels here and there, and voila, like that's it for me, guys. So go and big up on yourself. Let me know in the comments if you like the hairstyle. I love it. This was like 3 days after this part. I shoot this 3 days after I did it, and guys, I am loving it. I am still rocking it. I'm gonna try wear it for a couple weeks. So go and big up on yourself, people. See you all in my next video. Bye, guys.